question that I have chosen today is, a kite is in the shape of a square with the diagonal 32 cm and an isosceles triangle of base 8 cm and sides 6 cm each is to be made of 3 different shades as shown in the figure. How much paper of each shade has been used? If you see the board, I have underlined certain keywords, that is square I have underlined, diagonal I have underlined, the length of the diagonal I have underlined, base I have underlined, and then the sides 6 cm I have underlined. And see here, one more important word that I should underline is 3 different shades. See, this kite is not new for you. The kite here, in this kite, they have made 3 shades. First shade, second shade, and third shade. See, in the first shade, there is different color. In the second shade, there is different color. In the third shade, there is different color. So, what you are asked to find out is, you are asked to find out the shades, the areas of these 3 shades. Now, see, as soon as I read the problem, from the certain keywords, I can solve the problem, 50% of the problem, by seeing the clues. For example, the shape of a square. See here, I can see the word square and I can see the word diagonal. And the length is 32 cm. So diagonals of a square are always equal and perpendicular bisector of each other. Because I know the property of square which I have studied in my previous class. So, in that case, what I can do is, I can say that the length of AD and the length of BC, they are equal. So, I can say here, the length of AD and length of BC, both are equal to 32 cm. Then, they are also perpendicular bisector. That means, they are right angles, they are forming here. So, this AO and DO, they are also, AO is equal to DO, they are equal to half the length of BC. So, half of 32 is equal to 16. So, children, from the keywords, I am able to solve the problem. Now, let me come to the next keyword. See here, since they are perpendicular bisector, if I take this triangle ABC, this is the base and this is the perpendicular. And you have already studied. So, area of shade ABC, area of this shade ABC is equal to half into base into height. So that means what? Half into base into height. And half into base is BC and A, height is AO. That means the base is the diagonal. So the length of the base, this diagonal is 32. And the height is the perpendicular bisector. That is half of 32 is 16. Half of 32 is 16. Now 2 ones are 2 and 2 16s are 32. So 16 into 16. And that is equal to 256 square centimeter. So children, I have calculated the area of the first shade. Area of the first shade, that is equal to how much? 256. That means what I mean to say is, this area is equal to 256 square centimeter. Now, let me calculate the area of the second shade. This is BDC. Again, the same thing will repeat because diagonals are equal. So, this length is 16 and this length is 32 and this length is 16. So, same thing I will repeat. Area of triangle BDC is equal to half into base into height. So, that is half into 32 into 16 and that is equal to half into 16 and this is equal to how much? 256 square centimeter. So children, this is my second answer. Second answer says the area of the second shaded part is 256 square centimeter. So out of 3 areas, we have calculated 2 areas. That is area of the shaded region 1, area of shaded region 2. Now let me come to the third shaded region. The third shaded region, as they say, it's an isosceles triangle. The base is 8 and the two sides are 6. Now again, we are provided with 3 sides of a triangle. And when 3 sides of a triangle are provided and you are asked to find out the area of a triangle, then we don't have any other option but we have to use Heron's formula. So again, I have written certain step in advance. We have to find out S first, and S means what? A plus B plus C divided by 2. So in this you can take any side as first side. Let us say this is A. A is 6 centimeter. I'll take this. I'll take it as say B. Say B is 8 centimeters, and say this is the third side C, that is equal to how much? 6 centimeters. So what I have done, children? I have taken first side A as 6, second side B as 8, and third side C as 6. Now from this I should calculate S, and you know how to calculate S. S is equal to first side A plus second side 8, that is B, and third side 6 divided by 2. So if I do so, how much will I get? 8 plus 6 is 14, 14 plus 6 is 20. So 20 divided by 2, and that is equal to 10. 10 centimeters is the semi-perimeter. I repeat again, what I have done is first side plus second side plus third side, that is 8 plus 6 is 14, 14 plus 6 is 20, and 20 divided by 2 is 10. Now I have to use the Heron's formula to calculate the area of the third portion. So the Heron's formula says you have to calculate S and S minus A into S minus B. Here we have to calculate S, and S is how much? 10. S minus A, that means 10 minus 6. S minus B, that means 10 minus 8. 10 minus 8, then again 10 minus 6. So if I calculate that, then what I'll get here is, I'll get here 10 into this 10 minus 6 is 4, 10 minus 8 is 2, and again 10 minus 6 is 4. So this, if I further simplify, how I can write? Let us see. See here, this can be written like this. See, if you want, 4 to 10 can be written as 2 multiplied by 5. Then again, this 4, I'll write it as it is. Again, this 2, I'll write it as it is, multiplied by 4. Now, square root of 4, 4 into 4 is 16. 4 into 4 is 16, and 6 square root of 16 is 4. 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 2 is 4, and square root of 4 is 2. And now what remains in the bracket is root 5. Root 5. So this is 8 root 5. And children, the square root of root 5 is 2.231, something like that, approximately, because 6 square is 36 and 5 square is 25. So we want square root of 5. Say actually 2 square is 4 and 3 square is 9. So somewhere it should be more than 2 and less than 3. So it is approximately 2.23. So what I'll write here is 8 into 2.231. And this will be equal to 8 ones are 8, 8 threes are 24. Carry 2, 8 ones are 8, 8 threes are 24, carry 2, 8 twos are 16, plus 2 is 18, carry 1, 8 twos are 16, 16 plus 1 is how much? 17. So 8 threes are 8, ones are 8, 8 threes are 24, carry 2, 8 twos are 16, plus 2 is 18, then 8 twos are 16. So approximately the answer is 17.84 square centimeter. That is the area of the third shaded region. So once again I tell you, whenever you read a word problem, underline the key points. The key points that I noted here is square and diagonals. So if square and diagonals are there, that means diagonals of a square are equal and they are perpendicular bisector. So with the help of this, what I did, I calculated the two diagonals are equal and also the perpendicular bisectors are, they are half of it. Then the third keyword was this triangle. Three sides of this triangle are given. If three sides of this triangle are given, then definitely we have to use Heron's formula. And once I say Heron's formula, means I should know S value. S is A plus B plus C by 2, and area is under root S into S minus A into S minus B. So children, what I advise you is keep on tracing the keywords, underline those keywords and try to relate those keywords with whatever you have learned and try to solve the problem by yourself. See, children, on page number 207, exercise 12.2, there is a problem. The problem is regarding the calculation of area of a trapezium field. In this question, actually what he has given is, he has given you the non-parallel sides of a trapezium are 14 meters and 13 meters and parallel sides are 25 meters and 10 meters. Now using this information, you are asked to find out the area of trapezium. Now let us see how that problem can be solved. See here, you all have studied in class 8 standard that area of a trapezium is equal to half into height into sum of two parallel sides. Now here, you see, I already know the two parallel sides. This is 25 and this is 10. So this will be equal to half into height multiplied by 35. So dear children, I may be the first person to teach you the last step first. Actually what he is asking is, you are asked to find out the area of trapezium. And you have studied in class 8 standard that area of trapezium can be calculated using the formula half into height multiplied by sum of two parallel sides. Already we know the two parallel sides of the trapezium. So I have kept that two values here. But the problem with me is I don't know the height of the trapezium. Now how to calculate the height of the trapezium? Now for that purpose, what we have to make is, you will have to make a construction. What is that construction? Construct CE parallel to AD such that AECD becomes a parallelogram. So what I should mention here is construct CE parallel to AD such that AECD becomes a parallelogram. So now children, if it becomes a parallelogram, then you know that opposite sides of a parallelogram are always equal. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. What I mean to say is, the length of AD is equal to the length of CE. So what I'll do here is, the length of AD is equal to the length of CE. And both are equal to how much? 14 centimeter. You can mention here, the reason is opposite sides of a parallelogram. Opposite sides of a parallelogram. Or opposite sides of parallelogram AECD. Now this is the first point that I have got. You may be wondering, sir, why you are finding out this length EC. I will come to that point later on. Now the next thing that I want to tell you is, if AECD is a parallelogram, so if this is 10 meter, again this will be 10 meter, the same reason, opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Now children, this total length is 25, out of which this length is 10. So this 25 minus 10 will be equal to this length 15. So what I want to tell you is, the length of EB will be equal to the length of AB minus the length of AE. So that will be equal to how much? 25 minus 10, which is equal to 15 meters. Now again you may be wondering, sir, what are you doing? You are asked to calculate the area of trapezium and you are telling us about the parallelogram. Now let me come to the point. The point here is, I am considering about the triangle CEB or BEC. What I have done is, I have tried to calculate the three sides of a triangle. Now you see, in this triangle BEC, I know the length of this side is 14 meters, the length of this side is 13 meters, and the length of this side is 15 meters. So what I have done is, with the help of the trapezium, I have constructed a parallelogram, and from the parallelogram, I have found the three sides of the triangle. Now what I do is, I will use the Heron's formula, and now you are well versed with how to use the Heron's formula. So one of the side I will take it as in triangle. I am talking about this triangle. In triangle BEC. I am talking about this triangle BEC. In this triangle, let us see what are the things given to us. See, the length, let me say that this side is A, this side is B, and this side is C. So, in that case, what I will say, A is equal to 15 meters. Say, B is equal to 14 meters. And say, C is equal to 13 meters. So what I have done is, I have calculated the three sides of a triangle. And now I will calculate the area of this triangle. So let me calculate the area of this triangle using Heron's formula. Now children, you are well versed with Heron's formula. S is equal to A plus B plus C divided by 2. So that means what? 15 plus 14 plus 13 divided by 2. So what I will get is 5 plus 4 is 9, 9 plus 3 is 12. So again carry 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 plus 1 is 4. So 42 divided by 2, which is equal to 21 meters. Now what I got here is, I got the length of side, yes, that is semi perimeter I have got it. Now I have to use Heron's formula. Now area of triangle BEC, area of triangle BEC by Heron's formula, if I use it, S into bracket S minus A into S minus B and into S minus C. This is the formula to calculate area of a triangle by Heron's formula. Now let me calculate it. What I will get is under root, see here, S is equal to 21. 21 into 21 minus A. A we have taken it as 15. B, S minus B means 21 minus 14. S minus C, 21 minus 13. So what I have done is, I have calculated, I am calculating the area of triangle now. Let us see what I get. This becomes 21 into 21 minus 15, of course it is 6, I need not tell you. So 21 minus 14, it is 7, and 21 minus 13 is 8. So I decide to simplify from here. Now see, 21 can be written as 3 multiplied by 7, 6 can be written as 2 times of 3, 7 as it is, and 8 I am keeping it as it is. Now if I simplify it further, see here, 3 multiplied by 3 is 9, square root of 9 is 3, 7 multiplied by 7 is 49, square root of 49 is 7, 8 multiplied by 2 is 16, and 16 square root is 4. So finally, what I will get is, 3, 7, 21, 21 into 4 is 84 square meters. So 84 square meter is the area of this triangle, 84 square meter. Now, obviously you may be thinking, sir, why are you calculating the area of a triangle? You are asked to calculate the area of a trapezium, whereas you are calculating the area of a triangle. What is this? Why you are doing it so? I will come to the point. See, now let me listen to what I am saying. I got the area of this triangle. Now, my final target is to find the height of the trapezium. So because sum of two parallel sides are already known to me, what I want is, I want the value of height. But I did not get that height so far, because what I have got is, I have got the area of a triangle. Now one more formula is there for area of a triangle, and that formula you have studied in your lower classes. And that area of triangle CEB is equal to half into base into height. So this formula already you have studied it, it's not new to you. So this formula, if I use it, half times of base into height. So area of this triangle will be half into. See here, base is 15 here. So I'll write the base as 15, and I need to find out the height. So I'll keep the height as it is. But you know, just now we have calculated the area is 84. Just now we have calculated here the area is 84. Now if I further simplify it, this becomes 84 multiplied by 2. This if I transpose it to left side, 2 by 1 into this 15, if I transpose it to left side, it becomes 1 by 50 is equal to height. This if I further simplify, then what can be done here is, see here, 3 5s are 15, 3 2s are 6, 3 8s are 24. So 28 into 2 is 56 divided by 5 is equal to h. So 5 1s are 5, 5 1s are 5, again 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10. So what I got is height is equal to 11.2 meters. Height is equal to 11.2 meters. So children, let me repeat what I have done here. I have been given with a trapezium whose non-parallel sides are given and also parallel sides are given. So, in order to find the area of it, the formula used is area of a trapezium is equal to half into height into sum of two parallel sides. So, half I have kept it as it is, and two parallel sides, you see, 25 plus 10 is there. 25 plus 10 is there. Now, I want height here. So, to calculate the height, what I have done is, I have used this Heron's formula. I have completed the parallelogram. These two will be equal to 14 each. Then this side is already given 30. This total length is 25 minus 10 is 15. So I have calculated the three sides. With the help of the three sides, I have found the area of the triangle. After finding the area of the triangle, I am using the same area and using the formula that you have studied in your class, lower classes, that is half times of base into height. With the help of this, I have calculated the height. Now this height I will substitute here. If I substitute this height here, then what happens is half into 11.2 into 25 plus 10. Now already 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10, and 2 6s are 12. So what I get is 25 plus 10 is 35. So this becomes 5.6 into 35. And children, I did not tell a class 9 student how to multiply 5.6 and 3.5. If you multiply, the final answer that you are going to get is 196 square meter. So we have calculated the area of a trapezium when its non-parallel sides are given to us. This is one of the most important questions which has been repeatedly asked in the examination. So children, go through it. If at all any doubt part is there, kindly bring it to my notice. I'll clarify your doubt.